So today we're doing back and shoulders. Yesterday we did chest and back, so we're just gonna overtrain the back. What we're doing here, I call these jackpots 777. You do 7 deadlifts, straight into 7 rows, back into 7 deadlifts, back into 7 rows. We're supersetting that with, I think we're gonna go heavy press, seated, just for a little bit more stability on the back. Let's get it. So on knee, just wanna go at a good pace. Like I said, you wanna get straight into the bent over row. You wanna be bent over a good amount. So we're gonna go ahead and start off with the 50s. Something a little light just to warm up into it. When you're coming down, wanna get a good stretch. Elbow straight down. Staying close so you got it held. You don't want to lose the way up. Stay close. Contract. Right back up.
So right now we're warming up with the weights. We're doing the 777 on the deadlift row. And we're taking a little bit more time in between sets, you know, to recover, because we don't want to go into cardiovascular failure before going to muscle failure, if that makes sense. So take about a minute 30 between each set. And with the presses, we're doing a seated press, so it keeps a little bit more stability in the back. You know, really you don't have to use any muscles that aren't really needed. Press the weight up, and when you're doing a press, you want to get a slight tuck in your elbows. You don't want them too flared out, you know, because I can. So we're gonna go ahead and hit the underhand reverse grip pull down on the hamstring. It's important to keep your chest supported on the pad. There's a pad here for a reason. If you're swinging and jerking when you're pulling the weight, you probably should lighten it up. No ego lifting with this kind of shit. We're really chasing the mind and muscle connection. This is really gonna help you get optimal development in your back. This is something that can put a lot of mass in your lower lats if you do it right. I'll demonstrate the form for you. So like I said, you have your chest supported on here, but you want to get a little bit of a lean action to it. You don't want to be too far forward, you want to be too far fucking back. You want to be right in the middle of the sweet spot to get a little gangster lean with it. And you want to pull with your elbows, don't pull with your biceps. Make sure you feel your lats contracted each rep. So I'm going to show y'all what not to do when you're doing this exercise. So, if you all the way down here pulling the shit, and you fucking, you swinging, and you fucking jerking and shit, man, you got four plates on you, but your back look like shit, I'm gonna need you to drop down to a quarter and get a good, this is what you should be doing. Pulling with your elbows, chest on a pad, and contracting your fucking back. That's what the exercise is for, man. Don't do the extra shit. Since we're doing back and shoulders, we're now gonna focus on the medial head of the shoulder, doing lateral raises. So it's important to once again pull at your elbows doing this exercise so you can focus completely on the delt You don't want to pull at your wrists. You're going to do more of a trap exercise. You're going to come up with your elbows. You can either have them straight up or, you know, facing forward. This helps me get a better activation when I have them turned in. Opposed to doing them like this, I get more of a range of motion right here.
Should people be swinging when they're doing these?
No, you should definitely not be swinging. So if they're swinging and jerking, it's probably too heavy for you. You want to get a good quality rep. It's better to do 10 sets of one quality rep than one set of 10 shitty ass reps. So make sure your form's on point. And for these, you should not be fucking... You shouldn't be doing all that, right? You want to keep it good, slow and controlled. Up, and stretch back down. Up, straight back down. You don't want to be fucking swinging and fucking jerking. You know what I'm saying? If it's fucking too heavy for you, drop the ego and lighten up the weight, man. Nobody's going to judge you or laugh at you if you're hitting 10s, 15s on this shit. As long as you're doing the form right, you can build strength over time. You can't rush the process.
So we're going to go ahead and jump straight into lat pull downs behind the neck. With these, you want to get a lot more forward than you usually would. Get these on your hips. You always want to, when you're doing a pull down, you always want to keep like a dead hang. So where it's a dead hang, they use, just use their lats. This is going to get that mid back, the head of the cobra back. You guys ever seen that? You know what I'm talking about.
Okay. There you go.
So now we're gonna go ahead and get into the face pulls with your grip. You wanna overlap it on the top so that when you're pulling, it's a lot more comfortable for you. Go ahead and lessen the weight up. You know, it's not, I'm not ego lifting.
No egos, man.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not trying to impress nobody. I don't have nobody to impress. Now with me, when I'm pulling, when I get to here, I like turning my thumbs down and pulling. That gets that whole back of the trap, shoulders, instead of just going like this. That's more rear, but I like getting the whole package. Fuck. So we walking now, we getting all ready to dip, get in the car. I just remembered I gotta do legs again, third day. Day three, squat.
Back at it.
So since it's day three of legs every day, this is the most. Usually people hit that leg day, then on this day it'll be the fucking worst day of your life. But, you know, I feel pretty good, but we just gonna keep it light today. Just gonna do the place again. You know what I'm saying? Ain't gotta do nothing too crazy. Go ahead and jump into the workout.
There you go. Come on. Let's go. Finish. Come on. There you go. how you feeling, man? Day three.
Man, I said earlier, man, day three would be the worst day of my life. I'm getting 2 days. I'm gonna hit back past 2 days. I'm on weak legs. I'm doing legs for 3 days straight. Right now, my shit's just pumped. Regardless if I hit that set or not, man, my shit's pumped regardless. But it feels good, you know what I'm saying? I feel like my knees are feeling a lot better, honestly. That's one of the goals that I was trying to get. I was trying to attain doing this squats every day for the next 30 at least. Trying to go above and beyond. Above and just keep y'all updated.